120 Illini Road in Sherman, Illinois. Again, it's 7 o'clock, and brings us to the opening on the agenda. So what I'd like to ask is everybody to stand, face the flag. I am going to ask our president of the Fire Department Board of Trustees to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. So Mr. Burge, if you could please come forward on your cue, lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, now we can set the agenda. So the agenda's been posted 48 hours in advance of this meeting in accordance with the Open Meetings Act. There will be no action item added to this agenda. The chair will entertain any trustees seeking recognition for the purpose of discussion only. Are any trustees seeking recognition? Okay, seeing none, the chair will entertain a motion to set the agenda. Trustee Rockford makes a motion, seconded by trustee who wants it.
Good.
Trustee Malm, all in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, the ayes have it, the agenda is set. In the interest of our guests and the interest of time, instead of doing some of the technical stuff, what I'd like to do is invite some of our very, very well-performing students and athletes forward. We've got a few recognitions to do this evening, and then if they want to leave at the conclusion of the awards ceremony recognition component, you can. If you would like to stick around and watch the rest of the village board meeting, you are more than welcome to do so. So, let me start off real quick with a certificate of appreciation that was just presented to the Sherman Police Department that I'd like everybody to know about. Officer Ryan P. Howard has been recognized for exceptional support to a soldier stranded 162 miles from his home of record. On 20 May 18, an Army warfighter's engine belt snapped off his personal vehicle. Officer Howard contacted a taxi to transport him to a nearby city hotel and efforted in ensuring the hotel was in a safe location. Officer Howard then sat and conversed with the soldier until transportation arrived. The 376th U.S. Army Firefighters, Granite City, Illinois, proudly recognizes your dedication and professionalism in services provided to this military service member. Your actions reflect great credit upon yourself, your employer, and the Sherman, Illinois community. And it is signed by a commanding officer and a non-commissioned officer in charge. I'd just like to say that Officer Howard is not here this evening. He is actually at our training date, shooting at the range. But that being said, let's give Officer Howard a round of applause. Okay, let's move along. Can I ask Skylar Friedman please come forward? Mom graduated with me. She was in my class. Well, Skylar has had a pretty interesting last couple of months, right? The last endings of the school year. But this proclamation is going to be presented to Skylar on behalf of her accomplishments. What I want to do is I want to read this aloud so that I don't forget anything, and then I want to present it to you. So, Village of Sherman, Illinois, proclamation honoring Skylar Friedman, National Gold Medal winner. Whereas the Village of Sherman wants to show its appreciation and admiration for Skylar Friedman, a local eighth grade student, for her national recognition for exceptional artwork. And whereas Skylar was assigned to do a piece of art of expression from scratch and chose an expression of a, what? Bored teenager?
Yeah.
Not bored of your argument. Whereas Skylar's art teacher, Deb Larson, found her artwork from this typical art assignment to be exceptional and submitted it to the Regional Scholastic Art Awards, where teens in grades 7 through 12 apply in 29 categories of art and writing, and nearly 350,000 pieces are submitted. And whereas Skylar's artwork is on display at the Regional Scholastic Art Awards Exhibition in Springfield in January, where she received a gold key pin and certificate, and her artwork was submitted to the New Berlin Art Fair, where it received a blue ribbon. And whereas Skylar's work was submitted for national consideration in New York City, where a panel of judges from around the country reviewed it and other pieces in a number of categories, and whereas Skylar received a letter in March that she was being awarded a national gold medal for her artwork and was recognized at the Scholastic Art and Writing National Ceremony at Carnegie Hall in June, and whereas her artwork was on display at Parsons School of Design in New York City and will go on tour to additional exhibitions around the country for the next 18 to 24 months, including at the U.S. Department of Education and the President's Committee on the Arts and Humanities. Therefore, be it resolved that the Village of Sherman honors and congratulates Skylar Friedman for showing that the ordinary can become extraordinary with real talent behind it, and for earning this national recognition. And be it further resolved that a suitable copy of this proclamation be presented to Skylar and her family as an expression of our esteem and respect. Signed this 24th day of July in the year 2018. So very, very good job. I want to present it to you. Mom, do you want to get a quick pick up here with us? Deputy Chief will take a pick real quick. Very good, very good work. You make us all proud. All right. Thank you very much. Another proclamation we'd like to present, Elizabeth Blyer. Where's Elizabeth? How are you?
Good.
Good. So we have another proclamation for exceptional work. Honoring Elizabeth Blyer, the IHSA Journalism Champion. Whereas the Village of Sherman wants to show its appreciation and admiration for Elizabeth Blyer for her state championship for Williamsville High School in journalism. And whereas Lizzie won her first place in the Illinois High School Association Journalism State Finals for headline writing at the April 27th, 2018 state competition in Charleston to cap off her senior year. And whereas Lizzie competed against students from around the state in headline writing competition, and whereas Lizzie finished ahead of students from much larger schools and communities in the headline writing category to win the championships, including from several suburban Chicago schools and from the Bloomington Normal area. And whereas Lizzie's state championship is the second for Williamsville High School in the 2017-2018 school year. Therefore, be it resolved that the Village of Sherman honors and congratulates Elizabeth Blyer for her outstanding achievement as a state champion in journalism, and be it further resolved that a suitable copy of this proclamation be presented to Lizzie and her family as an expression of our esteem and respect, and road signs will be installed at the village's entryways to acknowledge her fantastic accomplishment. So very good work signing this 24th day in the year of 2018. Very good work. All right. So we have another special recognition ceremony for numerous individuals who displayed some awesome teamwork. Let me ask the softball team to please come forward. Okay, so we have the softball team. Coaches, come on, get in here. Mackenzie McCormick, where's Mackenzie? Mackenzie's here, hang on, I'm just going to name off everybody real quick. Skylar Dees, Ashley McDermott, Ashley, Emma Holbert, Peyton Long, where's Peyton Long? I know Peyton very well. Peyton watches my kids. Olivia Feltz, Emma Newton, where's Emma? There's Emma. Molly Walter, Maddie Sloman, Riley Yard, Maddie Murphy, Maddie here?
No, sorry, last minute change.
Okay. Lauren Sinks.
She's not here.
Okay, she's not here. Okay, we have Coach, Mrs. Mindy Ashball, Matt Mead, Tasha Shade, and Travis Woods. All right, real quick, I just want to name off some of their accomplishments before I read the proclamation, but the 2018 third place IHSA class AA state champion. You guys were awesome. It was really exhilarating, the lead up to all of this, the teamwork, the way that you pulled together and brought the community together. I can't, you know, stress that enough, but that was truly awesome. That being said, 6 Sangamo All-Conference members on this team, 4 ICA All-State members, 4 SJ Hour All-State prep players. Daniel Dennis, I'm going to point out a few accomplishments real quick. Daniel Dennis broke the Williamsville career home runs record with 25, the career hits record with 202, and the career RBIs record with 187, and was also the All Prairie Illinois Softball Player of the Year for the second year in a row. Very good job. Emma Wahlberg broke the Williamsville career hits record with 204, career batting average record with a .500 average, and the career singles record with 193. Peyton Long broke the Williamsville career strikeouts record with 670 career Ks, and their record was 34-6. So this makes them the second winningest team in Lady Bullets history and the Sangamo Conference champions for the 12th straight year. We wanted to do something special for you, to recognize you. I know Williamsville has already done that, but we wanted to do that because we're, you know, sister communities here. We share the same school district, we're all in this together, as Mr. Quimby would say. So this proclamation states that Village Sherman, Illinois, honoring the 2018 WHS Lady Bullets softball team for their outstanding 2018 softball season. Whereas the Village of Sherman wants to show its appreciation and admiration for the Williamsville High School girls softball team for its excellent 2018 season. And whereas the Lady Bullets finished with an impressive 34-6 record and third at the IHSA state softball tournament. And whereas the team had a great regular season and a strong run in the postseason, beating teams from New Berlin, Pleasant Plains, Gillespie, Alton, and St. Joe Ogden leading into the state tournament. And whereas, after a heartbreaking loss to Beecher High School in the state semifinals, the girls rebounded nicely to end the season in third place with a commanding win over Pickneyville in the Class 2A tournament. And whereas the team, led by Coach Mindy Ashball, carried itself with class and determination all season long and showed how to combine talent with teamwork to reach new heights. Therefore, be it resolved that the Village of Sherman honors and congratulates the Williamsville High School girls softball team for its tremendous 2018 softball season, and be it further resolved that a suitable copy of this proclamation be presented to Coach Ashball and the team as an expression of our esteem and respect, and road signs will be installed at the Village's entryways to acknowledge their outstanding season. Signed this 24th day of July in the year 2018. So, Coach, I'd like to actually present this to you if I could. Don't go anywhere just yet. We would like to also present you with these duplicate signs that we do for our student athletes when they get signs. So here's what the signs look like. Some of you have already seen them. This is what the highway signs look like on the highway. We have Trustee Long, who actually takes care of all of this, has these made He's our guy on this. But we have one of these for each and every single one of you to put in your office, put in your dorm, put in wherever to follow you the rest of your life. You look up on that wall, you get old like us, and you think back to look around at each other right now. I mean, just look at each other. That teamwork, that camaraderie that you had, and that special season that you had, and special years of high school that you had. So I want to hand these out to each of the ladies. I'm going to actually ask Trustee Baum, who has a very good connection here, to assist me. You want to get these out for the girls that you've been taking selfies with for quite a while now?
We have 26 girls on our team, and obviously several of them had other commitments and things like that tonight, so that would be great if you have them.
Yeah, I got them right here.
Thank you.
Yep, so very good. I also want to say real quick that we have other highway signs being made for our other individuals with their accomplishments. Okay. But that being said, let's scrunch in real quick and get one last picture here. Where's Sean Nick, Director Sean Nick of our Public Works Department? Not missing anybody else. Do I need anyone else? Good job, girls. Friday is going to be Parents Night Out. By popular demand and the most votes, the movie that's selected for Parents Night Out is going to be Top Gun. There's flyers as you walk in, so if you get a chance, parents, this is your night out. You get a babysitter, come hang out and watch a movie in the park. We also have live music prior to the show. Jimmy Reamer Jr., he's a sophomore at the University of Georgia. He lives here. He's does a lot of events, kind of a one-man band type of show. Very good. He's gonna play for a little bit at the amphitheater, and then we're gonna have the showing of Top Gun. So please try and get out to that. I gotta tell you that it's sponsored 110% by Green Family Stores. They've underwritten and give us this series of five movies for free at the amphitheater. They take care of it all. So Top Gun is Friday night. The next night, on Saturday at the amphitheater, again, another Green Family Stores movie brought to you, is going to be the movie Coco, so a good family kids movie to bring you out to. Pre-show activities from 7 to 9 includes a giant bounce house, face painters, games for the entire family, there'll be food by Chick-fil-A, drinks and snow cone vendor available, movie at dusk. Drinks and popcorn during the movie are provided by Green as well. Should have said on Parents Night Out, we have Hickory River is going to be the vendor for that evening. Bring your chairs and blankets. There'll be beverages at the event, so you don't need to bring a cooler or anything like that. So we'll have all that provided as well. Let's move along. Let's go back up to the clerk's reports. The presentation of the July 10th, 2018 regular meeting minutes. Those were presented for approval. Is there any additions or corrections to the minutes as presented by the clerk? Seeing none, the chair would entertain a motion to approve the minutes. Trustee Tim makes a motion. Is there a second? Seconded by Trustee Rockford. Clerk, please call the roll.
Trustee Long?
Yes.
Trustee Rockford?
Yes.
Trustee Tim?
Yes.
And myself, yes. And myself, yes. That's four members voting yes. The minutes, having received a constitutional majority, are declared passed. Presentation of the July 10th, 2018 executive session minutes. Any additions or corrections? You can't really state those out loud. But you've had time to review them, so is there a motion to approve the executive session minutes? Trustee Long makes a motion, seconded by Trustee Rockford. Clerk, please call the roll.
Trustee Long?
Yes.
Trustee Rockford?
Yes.
Trustee Tim?
Yes.
President Boswell?
Yes. That's four members voting yes, none voting no. The minutes are approved. Presentation of bills for approval. Your board member packet has the detailed warrants list of the various different bills. I don't think there's anything outside the norm here to point out. Are there any trustees seeking recognition questions for the bills? None. We need a motion to approve the bills for payment. Motion to that effect. Trustee Tim makes a motion. Seconded by Trustee Long. Clerk, call the roll.
Trustee Long?
Yes.
Trustee Rockford?
Yes.
Trustee Tim?
Yes.
President Boswell?
Yes. That's four members voting yes, none voting no. Bills are approved for payment. There will be no treasurer report this evening. That's once a month. Village engineer has the evening off. There is no legal report this evening. Move to the village administrator and economic development coordinator. Report, president's report. I already announced some of the things. Let me see here. The parrots in the park, I want to let everybody know, was a big success. We had easily over 750 of visitors to the park. I already said the movies. Website and our Facebook page has lots of information you can find on it, on events that are coming to Sherman or planned for Sherman. So always stay in touch. Like the Sherman, the Village Sherman Facebook page, or get on the shermanillinois.org website. That's going to bring us to committee and department reports, and there are none. Chief Banger, anything to report from the police department? No report? Sherman Emergency Management Agency Director Michael Moes has the evening off. He's out of town on business, I believe. Public Works Director Newton, anything?
No.
There is no new business. There is no old business to come before the board. There are no civic organizations seeking recognition. That's going to bring us to the public comment period. We have a sign-in sheet that had one, 12 individuals sign in. I have three yeses that would like to address the board. I'm going to call them forward. For the record, you can state your name, your address, and then I will start the clock. You have 3 minutes to present to the village board under our public comment period policy. I will turn my phone on. You will hear the timer go off. I'll let you know when I'm setting it. So the first individual who signed in to speak is Mr. Ed Carter. If I could have Ed please come forward. When you start talking.
My name is Ed Carter. I'm in Carter Lane, Springfield, Illinois. I'm just here to kind of clear up the responsibilities of the State Journal Register regarding the cattle and our feed going in. A year ago, concerning the property south of Steeplechase, John, the old administrator up here at Sherman, called me on March 31st. My cows got out due to a tree fell on the fence. April 4th, he called me. The river had come out down there and washed some of my fence out. Cows got out and put them back in. On the 5th of May, we moved all the cattle to the 50-acre field out front next to the highway. We had no cows on our 40 acres. It's on the other side of the tracks. Everything had been moved over here. We have witnesses to verify that. The old administrator up here at Sherman, John, even verified that. He came down and looked. On the 9th, my son and I, Josh, went up to the village. We talked to Mr. administrator. They presented me with a bill, a fine at the time. Clapped out and said, well, he can just stick this in his pocket for the time being. We was kind of in talks about moving the old trailers out of the field, and that's kind of what the goal he was after. So I just wanted to set the record straight. Our signs down there on the fence have nothing to do with my cattle back over there. It's strictly to let people in Sherman know what's going on with our board. And there's going to be more signs to go up on our fence. So next year is going to be a new election, so you'll see more of it.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Carter. Next individual who has signed in to address the board is Josh Carter. Josh, if you could please come forward.
Hey there, guys. I'm Josh Carter. I'll be pretty quick. I only really signed up to kind of cover anything that he missed on the meeting that we had with Platte Filter that about the cattle being out there. One of the big things that I want to push is things that were said at that meeting. We actually told Mr. Swinford, Mr. Clackfelter, that gates were open on that property, and if there were any cattle over there, they would actually be running the streets of Steeplechase. About the only thing that I can think of that he missed in the meeting, again, we went up there because of complaints, but they are completely unfounded in the fact that there is 40 acres over there that's actually in the county that we run cattle on. And we all live in Illinois. We know how storms work. We know how trees come down. And those occasions where the fences come down, it takes us a few days to get over there. We're actually very thankful that we have that back fence over there that stops cattle from getting all the way to Steeplechase. So we ain't got to go out in the middle of the night and try to chase down cattle. Had it happen many a times. If Eric Smith was still here, my grandpa has a very funny story, or he's passed now, but he always had a funny story about Eric Smith trying to wrestle cattle to the ground, trying to get it back up there in them fields. But this is just a lot of issue that we keep having. We're not trying to have hard feelings with Sherman. I have said this from the beginning. We're not trying to do anything that the Carter family hasn't done here since 1948 when they moved up here. And that's about all I got to say tonight. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Josh. Okay, the next individual I have on here who signed in to speak is Mr. Sean Bolt.
Good evening, Sean Bolt, and I'm speaking, what my address, P.O. Box 417. I'm speaking on behalf of the chamber tonight. We have an event coming up September 15th. We are working with the Williamsville Sports Boosters. There used to be an event here in town. Lori Long used to help run it, the 3 Mile Lunch. We are trying to bring that back. We're going to name it the Bullet Dash. But we're going to combine the 3 Mile Lunch and a color run over in the subdivisions here in Sherman, September 15th. We hope for a great turnout, village participation, but just wanted everybody to be aware of the date. So.
Very good. Yeah. And we'll help you promote that.
Appreciate it.
Website, Facebook, and everything that we can do. Okay, that concludes the individuals who've signed in to speak. I will give that back to the clerk. There is no executive session this evening, which brings us to the adjournment resolution.
Question.
Mr. Hopgood, did you sign
in? I signed in.
Oh, you didn't mark yes or no. Do you want to speak?
Yes, I do.
Okay, well, you didn't mark it. That's why I didn't call on you.
I didn't understand.
Okay. Go ahead and come on forward.
Thank you.
Hang on 1 second.
No, go ahead.
Now. Okay.
Some of you know me. Some of you don't. My name is Jerry Hopgood. I live here at Sherman, 3315 Southern Road. I've been a resident of Sherman since 1972, when the population was 200. Through those years, I invested in a business, and I was the first one to open up Subway. And I invested in the property, my latest being 155 Possum Pass, a rental. It was vacant, so I put up a rental sign at the corner of Sherman Boulevard, Meredith Drive. A and hoping to get any calls as I have in the past. However, the sign was removed and destroyed. I inquired about such and was told there was an order to remove all signage. People with children would come and settle in Sherman because of the school system. And the fact my renters last year did that very thing. They bought a house in Steeplechase. And I asked the question, how did you find the place? The sign at the corner is Sherman Boulevard, Meredith Drive. I hope this decrees and revisit as the sign was not permanent. My wife wrote a letter upon request of a Bill Wise to the Banking Commission to establish the Sherman Community Bank. Now you probably are too young to know about it. I bought my first rental in 1988. I have built two units, a duplex, Sunkist, Wall Street. That's four units now, cause of tax. If I didn't care about the community, I would not have invested my time, my money. One person cannot rule. This is a village. It makes the village grow. We must work together. Mayor, I'd like to present this to your panel here to be put in the minutes.
Very good.
Okay, so that will now conclude the public comment period because everybody else did sign in yes or no, and I have no other individuals on here. I don't see anybody else there seeking recognition. So that brings us to the adjournment resolution. Is there a motion to adjourn? Motion has been made by Trustee Rockford, seconded by Trustee Long. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, the ayes have it. We are adjourned at 7:34. Thank you, everybody.